partaking of the we are on the shore of the Mediterranean. We're eating breakfast. And there is the Mediterranean out there. And I'll show you some members of our group. Right now we're at a theater at Caesarea by the Sea. Amazing. I can't believe we're here.
And you still say it's beautiful, right? I want to tell you how this place looked like 2,000 years ago. So as you see, with all these pillars, that's the first floor of the palace, which is...
It's really interesting. This was a hippodrome. This is where they had a horse races. Right here on the coast. And here's a tour group behind me. Big stadium. It was about 450 yards long. Okay, we're on day two of the actual touring. Here is Teresa. We are the headwaters of the Jordan River. All right, I've decided I just have to get a little video of this. This is Caesarea Philippi, and this is an ancient temple site. There were various temples, various altars for different religions that were here. And it's just an incredible experience. We've seen pictures of how this looked back when people actually worshiped here. There were structures built up against the walls and the caves here. And various altars. One right behind me is a goat altar. They sacrifice goats there.
When I look down from lofty mountain brand new and hear the blue and feel the gentle. Sings my soul, my Savior God to thee. How great thou art! How great thou art! Hallelujah!
It's a camera. That film makes
yeah, it's a video camera.
Okay. They make it so small then.
Set up on the net for $8.
got to get on the boat.
Slopes down, and you'll see behind it another smaller hill sloping up. If you walk through that, that's the Valley of the Doves. That's how Jesus got here, from Nazareth. When they kicked him out of Nazareth, so to speak.
Yeah.
One,
yes.
Two,
the fish is going to come up. Say it slow.
Everybody together.
Two. Three!
Woo! Okay, so when...
Don't worry, this is the holy water.
Okay, so when...
This is a replica of Nazareth.
Man.
Smells very bad right here. It's a synagogue.
Guess what? Rich people like to live in that, on top of the hill, overlooking the city and overlooking the view, right, till this day. So, even after almost 1900 years, they're still up on the hill.
This is a synagogue from the time of Jesus. The stone in the middle is the Magdala stone. That's a copy, but everything else is original. These are original stones, the original tabernacle. That's the entrance to the tabernacle, the entry area, the seats, the speaking area where the Magdala stone is. And the lighting isn't too good for this, but this is mosaics. This is the site of the Jordan River baptisms. This is where Teresa and I were baptized. We were baptized at another spot, actually, that I can't get to right now, but it looked similar to these.
Hello.
Jerusalem at the time of Jesus. That's our group. I need to go join them.
What we see here is a huge villa, actually divided into two. Well, you've seen Caesarea, right? You understand how big it was. I mean, how much money and investment. This is next to...
Not a city. It's almost like a diamond shape mountain. Pretty much flat, but not, as you can feel, it's not exactly flat. Okay? It's about, let's say, 800 yards long, and its widest point about 350 yards wide on its widest point. That was not restored, and was actually was not touched. It's actually the second on the left, from the left.
Wow.
And you can see the tremendous work that was done here.
Yeah.
By the way, why we don't excavate everything, do you know?
So you can show before and after?
No, actually no, but it's a good point.
Safety point?
No.
Money.
No money, no, it's not a matter of money. It's a matter that you leave some of the sites for future, more advanced archaeological techniques.
Oh, okay.
In years to come, yeah. The excavation, in excavation were 3 years, and then a few more years for restoration.
So Teresa, what do you think of Masada?
You can see a lot of these pillars have a black markings. There's enough room for everybody. We're a big group, but there's enough room for everybody, so everybody can see this. So you need to create a sauna. You need two things. What's your head? You create two things. You need heat and you need water. So they would light a fire outside the hot room, outside the sauna, and they push the hot air underneath the floor.
Wow.
So
caught by the aqueduct and then diverted into these side cisterns. Now those side cisterns still exist. They are downhill and they are, some of them are small, like a small court, basketball court size, carved out of the rock. Okay. Alright. Great. You saw that, ignore the sound. Alright? The speech of Elazar, which is use mine. The speech of Elazar, which persuaded the people to take their own life. Okay?
Since we long ago, my generous friends, resolved never to be servants to the Romans, nor to any other than to God himself, who alone is the true and just Lord of mankind. The time has now come that obliges us to make that resolution true in practice. And let us not at this time bring a reproach upon ourselves for self-contradiction. While we formerly would not undergo slavery, though it were then without danger, but must now, together with slavery, choose such punishments as also are intolerable. I mean this upon the supposition that the Romans once reduce us under their power while we are alive. We were the very first that revolted from them, and we are the last to fight against them. And I cannot but esteem it as a favor that God hath granted us, that it is still in our power to die bravely and in a state of freedom, which hath not been the case with others who were conquered unexpectedly. It is very plain that we shall be taken within a day's time, but it is still an eligible thing to die after a glorious manner, together with our dearest friends. This is what our enemies themselves cannot by any means hinder, although they be very desirous to take us alive. Nor can we propose to ourselves any more to fight them and beat them. It had been proper indeed for us to have conjectured at the purpose of God much sooner, and at the very first, when we were so desirous of defending our liberty, and when we received such sore treatment from one another, and worse treatment from our enemies, and to have been sensible that the same God who had of old taken the Jewish nation into his favor had now condemned them to destruction. For had he either continued favorable, or been in a lesser degree displeased with us, he had not overlooked the destruction of so many men, or delivered his most holy city to be burnt and demolished by our enemies. To be sure, we weakly hoped to have preserved ourselves and ourselves alone, still in a state of freedom, as we have been guilty of no sins ourselves against God, nor been partners with those of others. We also taught other men to preserve their liberty. Wherefore, consider how God hath convinced us that our hopes were in vain, by bringing such distress upon us in the desperate state we are now in, and which is beyond all our expectations. For the nature of this fortress, which was in itself unconquerable, hath not proved a means of our deliverance. And even while we have still great abundance of food, and a great quantity of arms and other necessaries, more than we want, we are openly deprived by God himself of all hope of deliverance. For that fire which was driven upon our enemies did not of its own accord turn back upon the wall which we had built. This was the effect of God's anger against us for our manifold sins, which we have been guilty of in a most insolent and extravagant manner with regard to our own countrymen, the punishments of which let us not receive from the Romans, but from God himself, as executed by our own hands. For these will be more moderate than the other. Let our wives die before they are abused, and our children before they have tasted of slavery. And after we have slain them, let us bestow that glorious benefit upon one another mutually, and preserve ourselves in freedom as an excellent funeral monument for us. But first, let us destroy our money and the fortress by fire, for I am well assured that this will be a great grief to the Romans, that they shall not be able to seize upon our bodies, and shall fail of our wealth also. And let us spare nothing but our provisions, for they will be a testimonial when we are dead, that we were not subdued for want of necessaries, but that, according to our original resolution, we have preferred death before slavery.
Okay, so this was the speech of Eleazar Ben-Yair. Earlier, we passed a weird spot where we found a lot of publishers. One of them had the name Ben-Yair. And archaeologist who excavated this place, he was sure before he was put out.
Are you enjoying yourself?
Having a great time.
At Masada. Going back to the cable car. You're on Masada.
Okay, so just to show you, explain what you're looking at. First of all, you'll see black lines. Almost all the buildings have a black line.
Since we long ago, my generous friends, resolved never to be servants to the Romans, nor to any other than to God himself, who alone is the true and just Lord of mankind. The time has now come that obliges us to make that resolution true in practice. And let us not at this time bring a reproach upon ourselves for self-contradiction. While we formerly would not undergo slavery, though it were then without danger, but must now, together with slavery, choose such punishments as also are intolerable. I mean this upon the supposition that the Romans once reduced us under their power while we are alive. We were the very first that revolted from them, and we are the last to fight against them. And I cannot but esteem it as a favor that God hath granted us, that it is still in our power to die bravely and in a state of freedom, which hath not been the case with others who were conquered unexpectedly. It is very plain that we shall be taken within a day's time, but it is still an eligible thing to die after a glorious manner, together with our dearest friends. This is what our enemies themselves cannot by any means hinder, although they be very desirous to take us alive. Nor can we propose to ourselves any more to fight them and beat them. It had been proper indeed for us to have conjectured at the purpose of God much sooner, and at the very first, when we were so desirous of defending our liberty, and when we received such sore treatment from one another, and worse treatment from our enemies, and to have been sensible that the same God who had of old taken the Jewish nation into his favor had now condemned them to destruction. For had he either continued favorable, or been in a lesser degree displeased with us, he had not overlooked the destruction of so many men, or delivered his most holy city to be burnt and demolished by our enemies. To be sure, we weakly hoped to have preserved ourselves and ourselves alone, still in a state of freedom, as we had been guilty of no sins ourselves against God, nor been partners with those of others. We also taught other men to preserve their liberty. Wherefore, consider how God hath convinced us that our hopes were in vain by bringing such distress upon us in the desperate state we are now in, and which is beyond all our expectations. For the nature of this fortress, which was in itself unconquerable, hath not proved a means of our deliverance. And even while we have still great abundance of food, and a great quantity of arms and other necessaries, more than we want, we are openly deprived by God himself of all hope of deliverance. For that fire which was driven upon our enemies did not of its own accord turn back upon the wall which we had built. This was the effect of God's anger against us for our manifold sins, which we have been guilty of in a most insolent and extravagant manner with regard to our own countrymen, the punishments of which let us not receive from the Romans, but from God himself, as executed by our own hands. For these will be more moderate than the other. Let our wives die before they are abused, and our children before they have tasted of slavery. And after we have slain them, let us bestow that glorious benefit upon one another mutually, and preserve ourselves in freedom as an excellent funeral monument for us. But first, let us destroy our money and the fortress by fire, for I am well assured that this will be a great grief to the Romans, that they shall not be able to seize upon our bodies, and shall fail of our wealth also. And let us spare nothing but our provisions, for they will be a testimonial when we are dead, that we were not subdued for want of necessaries, but that, according to our original resolution, we have preferred death before slavery.
Okay, so this was the speech of Eleazar Ben Yair.
We're at En Gedi. This is the general area where David was pursued by Saul. There's a water fountain here. And there are people in the water down there. including the little boy with no clothes on. Okay.
Hey, there's a picture of Teresa taking a picture.
All right, here we are at Qumran, the site of the finding of the Dead Sea Scrolls. There are many caves, thousands of caves in the area. Videoing, where are we?
At the Dead Sea. At the Dead Sea.
At the Dead Sea, the one and only Dead Sea.
And we went swimming.
Which is still dead, but it's getting smaller each year, supposedly. We went swimming. Some of our group here. Just arrived at the Dome of the Rock, and it is chaos, and we're going to have our pictures taken. Actually, Mount of Olives. Dome of the Rock is down there. So again, we've just arrived at the Mount of Olives, overlooking the city of Jerusalem, the old city, and the point where the Dome of the Rock is, where the temple used to be. We're taking pictures here.
Yeah. Bunch up. Bunch up.
I like you love each other.
That's perfect.
There's the Poteet family who are leading the tour. And here's our tour guide, Tal, taking their picture. Step. There's a step.
So the Garden of Gethsemane. It could be, some claim that some of these trees are old, are 2,000 years old. All right, but this is the most preserved when it comes to the trees themselves. Because it's a holy site, nobody touched the trees for so long. And that's the part that is unique. Now, please.
All right, we are in the Garden of Gethsemane, where Jesus went. He was betrayed by Judas up here. It was larger at the time of Jesus, but it's still here. This is the site. This is the same site. now the Garden of Gethsemane. Getting ready to have a devotion. Again, we're in the Garden of Gethsemane, and we've had a little prayer time, and of course we're sitting up against the wall on the perimeter of the garden, but looking down at the garden now. Have the garden all to ourselves for a while. There is a group up there to the left.
Peter Sank.
There they go, okay. Three people deep is two.
That was tight, wasn't it?
Abba Bashmayu, the Kadash Shmuch, Tite Malkuto, Neo Vesibiono, Aikan de Bashmayo, or Barra Hablan, Lahmos and Colonel Mono, Washbuklan, Alban Mahtohei, Aikan of Dofahnan, Spakel Haibain, Lotaran de Siono, Elo Fasolan, and Bishimitur, the Loki Malkuto, Hire of the Spectre, the Ola, Alway, and now. Jerusalem cross should be five crosses. There's two reasons. The main cross, the cross of our Lord Jesus. And the small crosses, those are the signs of the Gospels. Luke, Matthew, John, and Mark. So when they finish writing, they need to...
You can see the hell lights, but very good for us tomorrow.
Mm-hmm. We're in an olive store, looking at olive carvings. More of the Mount of Olives. And the city wall of Jerusalem, right on the other side. We're in the valley right now, Kidron Valley.
The edge of a neighborhood.
This is a U.S. consulate. We're riding past.
Thank you, Eva. Toda Eva.
Thank you, Abba.
This is the one who is less gleaming, whose bright stripes and bright stars through
heaven. We're talking about Old Testament now. We are very close to what we call the
the Patriarch Road. When Abraham take Isaac to Mount Moriah, they come, they walk on what we call the watershed, okay, on top of the hills. All right, Abraham take Isaac to church or a site. We talk about an area. The area on the outskirts of Bethlehem bought for a tomb for himself and for his family. So we call it a Patriarch and Patriarch cave, or Machpelah cave in Hebrew, which is the tomb of Abraham, Isaac, Jacob, Sarah, Rebecca, and Leah. Rachel was buried off-road, not in the cave.
So by the sea, the dead were here, the dead will live again.
Bethlehem, how still we see thee lie above thy deep and dreamless sleep. The silent stars go by, yet in thy dark street shineth the everlasting light. The hopes and fears of all the years are met in thee tonight.
Take all the pictures you want. Now we'll tell us when we go back to the bus.
Twelfth century crusader. This was built by the crusaders. Outside are the remains where you see the mosaic form. These are actually earlier, from a bigger church which was here during the time of the Byzantine, that's 4th, 5th, 6th century. Okay, so two Christian periods of time. As
well. Hello. Where are we?
Where David and Goliath fall.
Exactly. We're going to see that in just a moment, where David and Goliath fall.
Between the giant and the kid. Right now, why we stopped at this section of the valley? Why did we stop here? Because the Bible gives us the geographical description where in the Ella Valley. Okay, now the Ella Valley extends from east
and it's round enough that it can go into the socket of the sling and create enough velocity and speed to hurt Goliath. And also, this Goliath, you know, if you hurt him in the chest, he's got the scale armor, right? His knees are all covered. He needs a weak point. And the weak point in between the helmet and the face is the forehead.
There is another hill called Sukkot. Sukkot is the hill behind this needly bush. It's right there. So we're in between these two hills.
We are walking in a stream bed, which is the stream bed from which David took 5 smooth stones to kill Goliath. Of course, he only needed one.
Oh, I'm saying, well, it's the smooth that I found right here, but I'm going to show you what it means, smooth stone.
I remember as a little girl in the red water, looking at her
We need like a mustard.
We are going for a stroll down a pedestrian mall with a large group on us. Turn around. And we're going to catch a taxi back. The bus driver drove us here, but we're going to catch a taxi back. So here we are at the mall.
Oh, I don't know.
is the day that the Lord has made. We will rejoice and be glad in it. This is the day, this is the day that the Lord has made.
When we walk with the Lord in the light of His Word, what a glory He sheds on our way. While we do His good will, He abides with us still, and with all who will trust and obey.
Where Jerusalem was born, right down there. It's cool.
Yes, it is.
Right? Hinnom, cheesemaker, Kidron, all rendezvous. Now.
Okay, this is where the three valleys come together, and this is where Jerusalem was actually born, right there in the middle. I'll look to the west,
just hit it on
the or to the north actually, to one valley. We have the Temple Mount and so forth up there. See Gethsemane, see the Mount of Olives. Down here to the right is where Jerusalem was actually born.
And each stone has this, what do I call the picture frame style.
Yeah. Yeah.
These are the original stones from the time of Jesus, from the time of Herod. And you're standing, look, I don't know if I can tell you, Jesus walked this street, but he definitely knew it. This is something that was familiar. You're standing on an original Jesus time pavement, Jesus time.
Okay, as Tal just told us, these are steps from Jesus' time. These are definitely the walkway is definitely from Jesus' time. They had to dig out 40 feet to get down here.
Original inscription actually is in the museum. Okay, it is known as the what we call the place of trumpeting. So it's anyway actually Simon, the builder of the temple. So probably someone who was participating in the construction of the temple in Herod's time. All right. Okay. Carefully here, and then up the steps and to the south side.
The stone right here goes all the way to that wall and weighs about 70 tons. And there are stones that are even larger that were used in the construction.
We talk about the long history, 88 years is kind of nothing. But they added both Muslims, many Muslims and Crusaders added the smaller stones that you see. Okay, so what the Romans had destroyed, the Muslims, the Crusaders built up again. And that's why you have a lot of the smaller stones. They didn't use Herodian stones, okay? The Herodian stones. Some they did in the palaces. They combined the big wall there. This is the perimeter of the palace. So they incorporated some of the old stones.
I mean, this is just pieces of bedrock and bushes. All the way to the top. That's Mount Moriah. Okay?
The city of David. Well, city of David is also Bethlehem. But when he made Jerusalem the capital of the Jewish people, okay, this Jerusalem of his times ended up at this road where you see the buses parked. Okay? And the David
they tortured him, they cursed him, they spit on him, they mocked him. And of course, after he had to stand the trial of the Sanhedrin, and then they were sure that they're going to hand him to Pilate, he was probably shackled on a prison. Something like that, and this is exactly why these ropes are
Thank you.
synagogues. Okay, people. Everybody's here? Everybody can hear me? So you saw a lot of places to eat.
Shops that set up on dates, bagels, dates.
Okay. Here's Teresa walking to the Wailing Wall. This is a library adjoining the Western Wall. As you can see, there are people sitting in here facing the wall. Inside the library, joining the Western Wall. So you see the books here. And this artwork on this structure. People are actually facing the Western Wall in here.
And I point where exactly which arch we are, right here.
Okay, here we are walking in the Western Wall Tunnel. There's still excavation going on.
Now if I open that emergency exit, I would be at the men's section, and then the women's section, okay? Let this lady move, okay? Now, when the bedrock is out, they would use the these paving blocks. These are paving blocks. They found them on site. You see, there's no erosion on them. That means they were never used.
Now walking in an aqueduct. Been walking along the wall. All underground, of course, or at least as far as we're concerned, it's underground. Very narrow passageways.
Same streets anymore, but then when it comes to the location, emphasize, when it comes to the location of the trial, this is the location of the trial. Where the Via Dolorosa, the traditional Via Dolorosa, take you west, the second. Okay? That's north. That's west. Alright? That's west. Yeah, that's east. That means if you keep going all the way down, up the road and down again, you'll see Mount of Olives. Okay? I hope that clears in your mind. Now, why Muslim, Christian, Jewish? Of course, each community around its holy site. Muslims around the Dome of the Rock, Jews around the Western Wall, and Christians around the Church of the Holy Sepulchre, and we have another Christian Armenian community.
Okay, the tour guide just said, "People, I can now say welcome to the old city of Jerusalem." So this is where we are. The candy store here. Whoops. Sorry.
And the Roman soldiers command Simon Moses to carry the cross here up to the mountain of the Golgotha, Calvary, Calvary. If you didn't see, this is the Simon already given us.
Hi guys, coming.
Just had lunch and now we are relaxing a little bit. That's our group over there.
Faith.
bullet holes.
I didn't get the music.
What's his name in that song?
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Is that the name of it? Hallelujah?
Cohen's Hallelujah. Cohen's Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. I want that music. Or... Last day of the tour. So here we see the Mount of Olives, the Garden of Gethsemane to the left, the valley down here, and I'm currently standing in the area of where Caiaphas' house was, where the religious trial was held. We know it was somewhere in this area. This is where the wealthy people lived. So the path that Jesus took was from down here to up there, down the valley, back up here. Okay, we have the Mount of Olives in front of us, Garden of Gethsemane a little bit to the left, the walled city of Jerusalem to the left. This valley down here leads up to where we are, which is where the house of Caiaphas undoubtedly was, and where the trial of Jesus probably was. This is part of the authentic road that led up to this neighborhood.
But it's part of the street. And you can see beyond the street, there's a remain of another house. There's a remain of another house. You can see some... It's one house.
There are the remains of one house right there.
Lived around here. We're not 100% sure that this is his residence.
Okay, this is the area where Caiaphas' house was. Little plaza here. This general area is probably where Peter denied Jesus. And we look back here. You see the Mount of Olives and so forth. And Gethsemane. And Jesus walked up a road, undoubtedly. And here we have preserved a road.
Since we didn't wait in line over there, I'll show you something else.
So that is a road that comes up here, probably to Caiaphas. We're at the side of the Pool of Bethesda.
And the access to the path is on the other side. There's a ladder.
Pool of Bethesda. Pool of Bethesda, John chapter 5. Just a portion of the pool remaining.
Thank you.
this pilot.
Did you get that? Watch this.
Might as well call it a prayer.
Church of the Holy Sepulchre. It's got 1700 years of tradition behind it, so they've told themselves it happened there so often they've come to believe it. Did it happen there? Well, I suppose we have to concede it could have been.
This is Golgotha, the place of the skull. There's a bus station down to the base now, a minaret to the right, and the skull right up here. Jesus was probably crucified down here where this bus station parking lot is, right underneath the skull. Standing outside the garden tomb. His hands, his feet.
garden tomb area. We have been in the tomb and we have had communion. This is just an overview of the area. And this was the last official sightseeing event. We're going to have a farewell dinner before too long. This is an Elvis diner in Israel. Elvis diner.